Now, metaphorical and cultural significance is a beautiful thing, but no art form becomes important until someone can get rich off it. By the time theater was formalized in 6th century BC Greece, all plays were tragedies. The first comedies didn't appear for 100 years. The problem was these two guys, Plato and Aristotle. Both of them condemned laughter as a malicious reaction to the ignorance of others. Because moral people having such a hateful response could upset the social order, in Plato's imaginary city-state, the Republic, the leaders were forbidden to laugh. Now, that may seem kind of ridiculous to us today, that laughter indicates moral failing. But think about it. Are there examples where laughter does make someone seem insensitive or cruel? Laughing at the handicapped, laughing at the ignorant. We don't usually laugh directly at stupid people, but there are times we're given license to laugh at stupidity. Movies, TV, stand-up. Would Plato and Aristotle think that's okay? They would not. Their prescription against laughter had nothing to do with hurting people's feelings. It was that laughing at someone indicates a moral deficiency in you. The idea of laughter as sinister lasted for thousands of years. In the 18th century, Lord Chesterfield wrote, "There is nothing so illiberal and so ill-bred as audible laughter." And it's been described with varying degrees of derision as, quote, "the mind sneezing, the hiccup of a fool, and a kind of sickness, vulgar, invariably injurious, and sometimes fatal." Some people still believe that laughter is corrupting. Just a couple years ago, there was a Saudi Arabian fatwa issued against women who would dare to use LOL while texting, because just the idea of a woman laughing might arouse men. Frankly, I'm getting excited right now, and it was me who said it.